Okay, it's rap pack to my pulse flat. We keep it real, no false rap. I got four cars and they all black. Got four bras and they all
ballin', ballin'.
I came from nothing, it's nothing like it's nothing. Yeah, you know I done it. That is no discussion, bitch. I'm ballin', ballin'. I made a promise to my mama, I'm attorneys.
So, here we go, guys. We're gonna be unboxing and doing a mini review of the Xbox Elite 2. I can count. We have over here the Elite 1, and we have over here the Elite Not 1. We're gonna be looking at them both side by side comparison, and I'll let you know what the differences are. We'll be exploring whether you should be buying another Xbox Elite controller, or if the one you already have is good to go. So let's take a look. This is the original. You'll notice a slight color difference. We got a kind of a gray going on. Got a solid black over here. Now, over on the right side, I have the Xbox Elite 1 in white. It also comes in black. The Xbox Elite 2 only comes in black at the moment. They'll probably do a white down the road. You know how they do. So, first thing you're gonna notice, aside from the obvious color differences, is that the entire controller has a blackout. Over here you have some kind of color differences. And over here, not so much. The other thing you'll notice right away is you got kind of a stippled pattern for grip over here. Feels okay. This is the first time I'm holding this controller, so you get to experience it with me. Feels all right. Feels cool. I'm not mad. Now, this controller only has it on the back side. This controller has it back side, everywhere you're gonna be holding it. And also has, I guess, some stippling here as well. Feels good to pull the triggers, I like it. So, as we look inside, we see the accessories. These are here because I do not have them in the back at the moment. So, the paddles on the back can be taken off of both controllers. Hopefully, I don't look like an idiot. Both controllers. And put back on. Easy peasy, lemon breezy. There you go. So, let's take a look at what they include in each one. So, you got this right here. This is for the tension, so that you can adjust the tension in your thumbsticks. So right here. I'm not gonna adjust the tension too much because I haven't really played with it. I don't even know what I wanna do with it. But yeah, you can turn this little screw. Yeah, you can feel the difference immediately. Okay, so you can feel it snap into place as you adjust from 1 to 2 or 2 to 3. Three levels of adjustability. While over here, you have none. None adjustable. All right, let's take a look, see what else they gave us. So it looks like with both the 1 and 2, you get 2 additional concave and convex thumbsticks. Except for, actually on this side, only 1 is tall. So, let me show that to you guys. So with the Elite 1, you get 2 tall and 2 short. With the Elite 2, you get 3 short, 1 tall. Seems weird. I feel scammed. Okay, so. As you notice, Xbox Elite 1, your 2 with the dips are tall, the other 2 are not. Over here, your 2 with the dips are short, and then you have a 3rd one, got your little dippy going on, it's tall. And then over here, you only have 1 that matches up with these. Not sure what they got going on with that, but guess I'll find out. Now, on your controllers, the base thumbsticks are, they look about the same. Let's pull one of them off on each and let's see. Yeah, they're pretty much identical. But if I'm looking at the base where they slide in, I don't think that they, nope, they aren't interchangeable. Not interchangeable, guys. Don't know why they went that route. Would've been nice. That way, if you owned an Elite One and for some reason you like those better, or hell, you even lose one over here, you could just take one off your Elite One, pow, you're good to go. That's not the case. So yeah, we'll be moving ones. Now, they both come with this. Guys, if you haven't used this particular D-pad on the Elite controllers, I have to tell you, it's literally the best D-pad I've ever used. I used to really like the PlayStation D-pad, and I hated the Xbox D-pad. It was just a little too firm, especially if you played any fighting games. It was just hard to like make the rotations to do the abilities and moves and stuff like that. So when they came out with this, it just feels so nice. Fighting games, any game, especially fighting games, like it's a cinch to pull off any combo you want. It's lovely. So I'm glad that they had that. They kept it from both series. Feels pretty identical in both. So I couldn't tell you if I liked one over the other. But also the Elite game pads, they come with a D-pad you can put on. And to be fair, the D-pad that you can put on is noticeably better than the D-pad that comes with a standard controller. A little clickier, a little bit more responsive, and a little bit easier to use, not as firm. So when it comes to hitting diagonals and doing the moves that you would use for a typical fighting game, it's no problem either. So if you get yourself an Elite controller and you don't like this, you can go ahead and snap on the little cross and you're good to go. You'll be happy. Let's see what else they gave us in the box, guys. They gave me this. I don't know what this is, though. You would think a guy like me would do his homework so I could sound like I know everything. It looks like a charging thing. Oh, snap. Yo, Microsoft hooked you up this year, guys. So, if you want to charge your controller, you can drop it on this base here, and I assume it will probably line up pretty well on its own. But yeah, drop it on the base, and it's going to charge. How much charging it will do, how long it takes, and how many times you can charge, I'm not 100% sure. But it's cool that they included it in, so you don't always have to reach for an outlet, especially if you're like at a gaming event or a party or something like that. You don't have to be that guy who like reaches for the cord. Also, they have a little plug here. I don't know if it sends power out, but if you could do like a USB-C to USB-C to charge it, that would be pretty cool. That way you could charge it while in use if you were like playing on the go or something like that, or just not near an outlet. I'm guessing not. That's probably a lot to ask, but at least you can drop it in here and get the charging. So let's take a closer look at what's actually on the controller. All right, so you got this cool new controller. Actually, you know, I kind of wanted to get it in white, and they didn't have it in white because they don't make a white for the Xbox Elite 2. But this black is looking fine, you know? I'm actually very impressed. It's got its own kind of personality. It's looking good. Well done, Microsoft, well done. So let's take a look at what's going on over here. We have the little profile buttons over here on the Elite One, right? Has one and two. Over here, we have three little lights. I'm gonna go on the record and say it's probably for three different profiles. So the Elite Two offers three different profiles as opposed to the Elite One with just two profiles. So if you share this, you know, with family, or you know, you got yourself a profile, you got your girlfriend a profile, and guess you got your other girlfriend a profile too. It's a very family-friendly controller. Good looking out. So on the back, the first thing I noticed was that these are shorter than the paddles on the Elite One. I'll go ahead and put the paddles on the Elite One real quick so that you can see, but I'm pretty sure they're shorter. Actually, they both look pretty short. No, they're shorter. Yeah, definitely. And that's another thing about these controllers, is that they are reasonably customizable, and it's a quick customization. There we go. So if you look at them side by side, the first thing you're gonna notice is that, well, this one wants to fall over, but that's because this one has a longer thumbstick on it right now, and this one has a shorter one, and it just wants to topple. But if it wasn't trying to topple, then the first thing you notice is that these are indeed shorter and a little bit smaller. So that means that you can grip the controller a little easier without worrying about unintentionally hitting buttons. Okay, okay. The Xbox Elite 2 controller definitely has far less intrusive buttons. Noticeably so. Quite noticeably so. I like it, it feels good. Definitely. All right, so let's take a better look at these paddles real quick. Okay, so after you put the paddles on, the first thing you're gonna notice is that they're definitely shorter on this side, longer, a bit wider on this side as well. So what that means is whenever you're holding it, you're not gonna mistakenly hit the paddles as often, or maybe even at all. They're very much out of the way. I have to intentionally want to press them like that. What I noticed with the Elite One is that they were kind of always sitting there begging to be pressed. And sometimes, yeah, you could definitely clench your fist a bit much in a gunfight and mistakenly hit them. Over here, you can hold your controller a lot more aggressively without fear of pressing the button. Plus, they're clickier. I'm getting a lot more resistance out of them. I like that. Now, it's not like a ton of resistance where you have to struggle to press the button, but immediately pressing the button is far more intuitive and more of a decision. Far more clicky on the Elite 2. That might be an occurring theme of this controller. It might have just been tightened up all the way around. They're both pretty clicky. They offer a reasonable amount of resistance. But maybe this one is a touch clickier. Maybe. Other than that, everything else appears to be pretty similar. You got the little holes in the bottom for different accessories. They're the exact same. You know what you're definitely gonna notice? You're gonna notice that you can't swap batteries. That could be the big uh-oh. That could be the big deal breaker for some people. And eventually, when everything else in your controller is working perfectly, but the battery inside is not, that could be an issue. See, the Elite 2 now has a built-in battery, while the Elite 1 was running on good old rechargeables. Well, if you're like me, you bought a couple rechargeables. And you know, real quick, let me PSA you guys real quick, public service announcement. If you're living life without rechargeable batteries, you're fucking it up. Go get yourself some rechargeable batteries. Not only will you help the environment, but you will also help your wallet. Facts. I haven't had to buy AA batteries in years, despite the fact that I use AA batteries every fucking day. Recharge your life, baby. Recharge. So, let's take a look at this, these differences real quick, because there's not a whole lot, but there's enough to make this controller feel noticeably different and possibly even perform a little different. And speaking of performance, the triggers. Now, if I squeeze the triggers, they feel pretty similar. The Elite 2 might have a little bit more of a hook. It's got a little bit of texture right here. All right, so we're back after some technical difficulties. We had some lighting issues, some battery issues, some issues. But here we go. I think the last thing we were talking about were the clickiness of the thumbsticks, all right? So I was saying that they both feel relatively the same on the Elite 1 and the Elite 2. But we didn't fuck around with the face button, so let's go ahead and do that. They feel pretty good, and I mean, the veins are popping now, you know? Ladies, get in the DM. My camera guy's over here. We checked our analytics, and our analytics are 100% male, so maybe there are no ladies in the DMs. But if there's any girls out there, you know where to find me. All right, let's check this out. So, feels identical as far as the face buttons go. Oh wait, hold up. The ones in the middle are a little bit more clicky, but your X, Y, B, A buttons, they're pretty much the same. I'm gonna go ahead and say they're the fucking same. Everything else feels identical. The weight is very close to each other. The biggest drawback I think you would find with the Elite 2 is that the battery is a rechargeable battery integrated. And like I mentioned before, everything on this controller will probably stay intact, but after you charge this thing a couple hundred, maybe a thousand times, you're gonna start to notice some wear and tear. Now, with the Elite 1, I got these handy dandies in here, rechargeable batteries. So if they start to wane, and I just pop a different set in, no problem, easy peasy, lemon breezy, titty squeezy. But if this starts to go, I mean, I guess you could take it to a controller specialist and have them swap it out, but at that point, it'd probably be cheaper to buy a new controller. Eh. So, here's a real question, right? This is what everybody's wondering. You got the Elite 2, you got the Elite 1. If you have an Elite 1, should you pick up the Elite 2? The Elite 2 is obviously better. So if you have neither, then this is the one you're gonna wanna look for. It does have a rechargeable battery, which for some of you who don't have rechargeable batteries laying around the house, it could be something convenient. Although, I suggest you do it anyways. Yeah! So as far as rechargeable batteries go, if you don't own some in your house and you have multiple electronics, you should get some. To save the trees, maybe, but even more so because it's gonna save you money and that's what you really wanna do. And it's super convenient. Personally, I prefer the ability to swap batteries out because if I'm gaming mid-session and they get low, I just pop it off, slap some more in there just like a Call of Duty clip and I'm ready to go. With this, I'm gonna have to pop a cord in or something. I'm gonna have to figure shit out. So, you know, whatever. Either way, from my experience with the Elite 1, if the Elite 2 is even better in battery life or just as good, you're gonna go days before you even need to swap batteries. I'm talking like, I game harder than probably 95% of you guys watching and definitely more than most people for sure. And I'm good for 2.5 to 3 days per charge. That's really good. So don't worry about that too much. So the real question is, let's say you do have an Elite 1. Do you get an Elite 2? That's the question everybody wants to know. I really like the Elite 2, even though I haven't had a chance to plug it up and use all of its features. I would say you probably don't need to. I know, right? As much as I like the way this feels and the upgrades they made, if you already have this one, you don't need this one. The biggest reason to switch over would probably be if you intended to use this for PC, because for some weird reason, this $200 controller does not have Bluetooth connectivity. But you can go to Target right now and buy one for $49 or $39 of Black Friday sale of standard controller does have Bluetooth connectivity. That has to be the biggest oversight that I've seen as far as controllers go. How your $50 controller gonna have Bluetooth and your $200 controller don't? Microsoft, I want answers. But if that's not the case, you're just doing the console thing, then yeah, just stick with your Elite 1. But if you have neither, all day, baby, all day. And if you're worried about additional colors, Then in the future, they'll probably offer white, but I'm not expecting them to offer blues and reds. They should, Microsoft, but they're probably not for these. So there you have it. So what do I give this? Is this a legit or is it a knob? It's definitely 100% legit. You just don't need to run out to the store and get it if you already have this. And if you don't have any controllers, then I wouldn't say you need to run out and get this one either. But if it's in your budget, yeah, sure, why the fuck not? You get a lot of paddles on the backside that you can remap to whatever button you want. So if you're playing Halo and you want to be able to jump a little easier, or you're playing Call of Duty, you want to slide, or any other game, even if you're playing Street Fighter, you know, you want this to help you out with some specials, you can map that, whatever you want to do. You got three different profiles. You, your two girlfriends, you can all game as one happy family. That's what I call family friendly YouTube. And of course, it just looks sleek. It looks a lot sleeker than I was expecting. An all black controller on paper doesn't sound that awesome, but if you look at it, this shit is sleek as fuck. So there you have it. It's a quick rundown review of the Xbox Elite 2 versus the Xbox Elite 1 controller. And I think I said all I need to say. You got shorter paddles over here. Everything's been tweaked a little bit better. I'm not just saying this. Everything has been made a little bit better to some degree. So if it's in your budget, there you go. Christmas is on the way, baby. See you guys in the next video. Legit or not, Connecticut out. Staying strong. Ladies, get in my DMs, even though there's 100% male viewer audience. Duh. I feel more defiant when y'all hate. Y'all the only niggas running in the car race. Serving nigga with a butter like parquet. Rap niggas also so strong, Jay. I'm a little bit of Pac, but a Kanye. You a little bit of Fox and Beyonce.